Resort. All the golf is thrown in, courtesy of PGA Travel, the golfing holiday specialists.
Well, our two players today, David Mensch from Geelong, and this is one of the Febes. I don't care whether it's Matthew or Steve, it's going to be Febes, but I know it's Stephen. But Febes, you're going first. And also on the Luma Bell, we've got our old pal over there, Dermot Brereton. And who are you supposed to be, Dermot?
Who knows?
Who cares?
One on one. OK, so five with the left hand, and I've got Sam Kekovic scoring for me. Come on.
Who's the judge?
You are.
Five.
Oh, I've got it right this week, eh?
Five. Right. This makes 10.
You can catch those net if you want to. 10.
Oh, 20. Don't overdo it, Dermot.
5. 25. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5. 5
David. Lift your game and watch your earring.
Five.
Turn your collar down, David.
Five.
Oh,
five.
Four, buddy.
Okay, fair enough. Don't argue with him.
15.
Come on, David, lift your game. Your girlfriend's over there.
Five.
20.
5. 25, Lou.
25 plays.
30.
So you're 5 in front. And incidentally, throwing the ball today is Craig Kelly, doing a wonderful job. Oh.
40.
Oh.
45.
5.
Playing well now, Phoebs. 50. 55. Oh, my leg. It's 6-0. 6-0,
Lou.
6-0, you need 35, 36 to win. I don't think you can do it, but try your best, son. And don't think of your girl when you're firing, either.
5. 30, Lou.
30.
5 more.
35, you're falling apart. Oh! 45.
He needs 2 balls.
5. 50.
He's history.
55. Bad luck, David. You've won that, Stephen. Good luck. All the great boys and go with it. Fantastic prizes. And of course, we'll be back with Max after the break. Well done.
Thank you, Kicker. Sam, we'll get the dictionary out shortly to work out those words. Welcome back. 3 games today to finish round 19 at the MCG. The Tigers must beat Collingwood to remain in touch with the top 8. Sydney and West Coast can improve their standings with a win at the SCG. And in a classic derby confrontation, Adelaide must win to remain in the 8, while Port, they must win to keep its finals chances alive. Kicker, Richmond versus Collingwood. The Buckley factor, will it have an impact?
I've got no idea, Max, but I do know one thing. Anyone that's got the capacity to spend $21,000 on a footy show table...
For charity.
For charity.
It's where they keep having a bark of a pig.
Lou, let me tell you. And they've got a players list that they've got at the moment.
They got it wrong.
I think they have got it wrong. But I think Richmond aren't travelling all that well either. But the fact that Buckley won't be playing, Williams is out, and Alex McDonald has been terrific for them. They're just down on personnel, and it's been fairly well documented. I think Richmond, with Richardson up forward, he'll have
Daffy.
Very quick tip.
Richmond for me.
Richmond, never 2 bad ones in a row.
Tigers down to the Hawks last week. They haven't lost 2 in a row this year.
They're
Tigers.
Oh, good one.
I'm going to stick with Collingwood. They're going to come good.
I'm going with Craig. Collie's a good judge.
Okay, I'll go with Richmond. Now, Dermot, Sydney versus West Coast. A lot at stake, but also an enormous quantity of water has fallen in Sydney in the last 48
Very
hours.
Very wet, and the surf's about 4 or 5 metres at Sydney, which is the important factor in this game. But no, look, West Coast, the goal-to-goal line for West Coast Eagles, if they were a Melbourne-based side with that type of list, they'd just about be favourites for the flag. But they don't travel that well. They've won a few games away from home this year, but only against mediocre opposition. I don't think they can really count that against Sydney. Really, either way, 1 goal in the margin. I'll go with West Coast.
Bob, the West Coast, 9 of the last 11, will win the grand final as well, mate.
That's enough.
We're Sydney Swans at home.
Just in case.
Swans. I've got the Sydney. What
I'm
have you got?
With Craig again, Sydney.
Thank you, Louis. You stick like glue, don't you? Okay, Craig, Adelaide versus Port. Can Port do it?
Well, the home derby or derby, however you want to pronounce it, after still recovering from the footy show on Thursday night, but one of the great matchups will be, or contests will be, Primus and Wren. And Rennie's certainly playing very well last week against, or the week before, against Everett. So that'll be interesting. And also McLeod's been in fantastic touch. I think the Crows will continue to go forward even without their captain, Mark Bickley.
I think the Crows.
Adelaide, well done to the Kerry Grammar boys too.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Way to go.
Crows, and happy birthday to Bobby Rose. What a great man, Luke.
Well, that's very nice to say that, and I'm going for the Crows too.
Okay, Louis, thank you very much indeed, gentlemen.
I'm going to footy today too,
yes,
mate.
Good luck. Let's get out of here very
well done,
shortly.
Matthew.
That does us for another week. Please stay tuned for Sports Sunday. This is unbelievable. We'll catch you again in 7 days' time. Until then, it is bye for now.
Coming up in just a moment on 8, Cross Country, then at midday our AFL live doubleheader, live from the SCG, Sydney and West Coast, then at 2:50 from Football Park, the Adelaide Crows and Port Adelaide.
This has been a presentation of Nine's Wide World of Sports, your Commonwealth Games network.